Higgsfield AI just dropped a new video face swap tool called Recast, and it comes with built-in voice cloning and dubbing. It's honestly as simple to use as it gets, and the output quality is easily among the best you'll find in the AI space right now. Here's one of the previews they show on the website. All you have to do is upload a video with a face, upload an image with a face, hit generate. And that's literally it. It's as simple as it gets. And on top of that, they have introduced Recast Studio, which takes everything to the next level with even more control and better results. So here's how the whole process works. I'm starting with this video. It's a scene from an action movie that I actually created earlier using Higgsfield AI with VO 3.1. The scene already looks pretty solid. Now I also have this plain looking photo of a man's face. You can directly use this as your swap face if you want, but I'm going to take it one step further. I'll head over to image Nano Banana to tweak the image a bit. I'm uploading the photo here and then typing in a quick prompt to make the face look a little tougher and more intense. Once I generate the four variations, I'm picking the one that fits the vibe the best and downloading it. To get to Recast from the homepage, just click on the Apps tab. You'll see a bunch of options pop up, but for today we are focusing on Recast. So go ahead and select that. Once you are in, upload your video. In my case, I'm uploading the action scene with the dialogue. After that, upload the character image we just created using Nano Banana. You will also notice a small indicator showing how many credits the generation will use. That mainly depends on the length of your video, so longer clips will naturally require more credits. After everything is set, just hit generate and let it process. The waiting time can vary depending on the queue, so sometimes it's quick and other times you might have to give it a moment. But that's pretty much it. The tool handles the rest. I got this result in about 3 minutes, so yeah, it can be pretty fast when the queue isn't too long. And honestly, the output looks as natural as it gets. It keeps the original background perfectly, and even in frames where there's extra movement or objects partially covering the character's face, the swap still holds up really well. Now, let's say I want to take this video even further. For that, I'm heading over to Recast Studio. This is where things get more interesting. You get all these extra options, preset faces, face swap tools, or the ability to upload your own custom image. There are preset voices for both male and female characters. And if you want, you can even clone your own voice for a more personalized touch. You can also change the language and even tweak the background if needed. It basically gives you full creative control over the final output. For this part, I'm going to try switching up the voice. And while I am at it, why not change the language too? So I'm selecting Hindi from the list. Let's see how this turns out. And here's the result.
Meri baat suno. Hamare paas zyada samay nahi bacha hai. Sab kuch phatne wala hai.
In just a few minutes, it generates a really polished, professionally dubbed version of the video. The voice matches the scene surprisingly well, and the lip syncing adjusts perfectly to the new language. It honestly feels like the video was originally shot this way. Now, let's move on to a slightly more complicated scene. This one has two characters talking to each other.
Oh, really? So is fate predetermined, or do we still have choices?
Just for fun, I decided to create a zombie character using Nano Banana, and I'm going to try swapping its face into the scene. Here's the result.
I already know what's going to happen tomorrow. I remember it.
Oh, really? It actually looks pretty good, but since the original character had a female voice, the zombie ends up sounding the same, which feels a bit funny. So to fix that, I'm heading back into Recast Studio and selecting a voice preset with a deeper, more bass-heavy male tone. After applying that, you can still notice a little room for improvement in how the voice blends with the character's look, the pacing of the animation.
I already know what's going to happen tomorrow. I remember it. Oh, really?
But honestly, considering how fast they are patching issues and rolling out improvements, I'm pretty confident we'll be seeing even more refined results pretty soon.
Why
What about simple talking head videos? I have got this short clip here and I'm going to replace the face with this one.
Why small choices we make every day actually shape our entire future.
After saving that version, I will take it a step further just for fun. I'm picking one of the preset characters from the list, an anime styled one that looks pretty cool. I'm also switching up the background by choosing one from the available options just to see how far we can push the look. Once everything is set, I hit generate and the result comes out surprisingly clean.
Why small choices we make every day actually shape our entire future.
The lip sync works really well too, even with the anime character and the new background. It actually feels like the character was meant to be in that setting. So yeah. You can use all these tools to generate really impressive videos within just a few minutes. The final quality is totally up to you. It depends a lot on how good your source videos and images are and how creatively you use the features. If you want to try it out yourself, head over to Higgsfield Recast. I will leave all the links in the video description so you can check everything out easily. Alright, that's it for today's breakdown. I hope you found this video helpful. And I'll see you all in my next video. Thanks so much for watching.
Every day, we wait for you to join us.